大家好，又嚟到 Hong Kong Survivor 嘅時間啦。數數手指咧，第二季咧又差唔多去到尾聲啦。而咁咧，今集我哋想同大家講嘅咧，都係會關乎於我哋喺户外嘅一啲需要用到嘅一啲物品啊。咁其實咧喺户外啦，可能進行一啲攀山啊、攀石啊，或者係可能一啲唔同嘅一啲求生嘅嘅情況底下咧，其實咧，我哋以下落嚟講嘅嗰一樣嘢咧，其實咧係非常之重要嘅，因為咧喺繩索呢一樣嘢咧，其實咧攀石、攀岩啊，或者可能有好多朋友仔喺室內攀石嘅話咧，其實咧繩索都係非常之緊要嘅。所以咧喺野外求生嘅情況底下咧，有一條繩喺身邊傍身咧係非常之緊要嘅。咁咧以下落嚟咧就想同大家講嘢講嘅就係呢個繩結啊。繩結咧，其實咧有好多唔同嘅種類啦。其實咧，繩結咧點樣去其實佢係可以係完全地去發揮到一條繩、一條繩索嘅一個作用啊。因為咧，透過唔同嘅一啲繩索嘅集結咧，就可以咧進行一啲固定啊，或者係進行一啲物件同物件之間嘅連接嘅。所以咧，綁得好嘅一個繩結同埋綁得正確嘅一個繩結咧，對於我哋嚟講咧喺求生方面係非常之緊要嘅。尤其是係如果你喺一個荒山野嶺嘅時候，然後啦，係要搭建一個帳篷，而你搭建帳篷嘅時候咧，係橫風橫雨嘅情況底下咧，你要搭一個非常之穩陣嘅呢個繩結啦，同埋一個係正確容易解到。因為點解會同大家講話容易解到咧？因為咧有陣時咧綁繩結嘅話咧，唔係話綁得實就一定代表係正確嘅，因為有好多繩結咧，其實係可以咧綁得穩陣之餘，其實你解嘅時候咧，亦都係非常之方便。咁有好多朋友仔啦，可能細個嘅時候都有參加過童軍啊等等嘅，其實佢咧都因為我以前有參加過童軍啦，咁其實都會有一啲考繩結嘅一啲章啊。咁所以咧，你喺可能細個嘅時候，如果你想培養自己小朋友有呢方面嘅求生意識嘅話咧，不妨咧叫佢哋參加下童軍啊，可以係學習下唔同嘅一啲求生技巧啦，甚至乎一啲繩索嘅一啲打繩結嘅一啲技巧嘅。咁其實咧，真係可以係生死攸關嘅時候救翻你一命嘅呢個繩結，因為繩結咧打繩結嘅目的咧，頭先都有講過下啦。其實打繩結嘅目的咧，最主要是結合兩樣不同的一些物件，或者是透過這個繩結產生一個防滑的一些作用，甚至乎是將一些繩結做一些固定的一些情況，令到兩個不同的物件綁在一起，就 作為一個連結的情況。其實在當你去到一個不熟悉的環境，荒山野嶺的時候，其實可能如果你要重新去學習點樣去打一啲有用嘅繩結咧，其實係非常之花時間同埋花上你嘅體力。通常如果你係去到一啲荒山野嶺嘅時候，我要求生嘅時候，通常你嘅技能上面、時間上面咧都係非常之緊迫嘅。所以咧，如果你係一早已經學識咗一啲有用嘅繩結咧，其實對於你嚟講係非常之緊要噶。咁啦，啱啱咧講咗咁多啦，咁我哋不如講下一啲你常見嘅一啲繩索嘅一啲繩結嘅打法啦。咁以下落嚟第一個咧，就同大家講嘅就係八字結或者係呢個雙八字結。因為咧有好多如果攀石嘅朋友仔咧，應該都會知道咧，八字結咧其實係依家目前嚟講咧，正式比賽唯一允許要嚟連接攀登者嘅呢個繩結嚟嘅。所以咧相對嚟講咧都係比較穩陣啦，同埋容易解開嘅。所以深受好多攀山啊、攀石嘅一啲行山人士啊，或者係一啲山地嘅一啲少數民族歡迎嘅一個 成結嚟嘅，所以好多時候都會見到。好啦，到第二個結咧，就會同大家講下呢個布林結啊，又可以叫做人結啦。可以稱之為人結嘅，咁其實咧呢個結咧就其實用途非常之廣泛啦，甚至乎係去到上山下海等等咧，其實都係可以用得著呢個成結嘅。打起嚟咧，呢個成結係非常之快嘅個速度，亦都係咧結實啦、可靠嘅，係圍繞住你嘅身體嘅中央咧做一個救生嘅繩索，咁樣咧就可以方便喺上即係繩索嘅上方嘅人可以救到你。如果係咁樣嘅情況底下咧，通常咧運用咗喺一啲跌落海啊，或者係跌落去山卡拉嘅地方咧，呢一個繩索咧就可以方便到你逃出你嘅呢個危機嘅。而第三個同大家講嘅結咧就係呢個雙套結啦。啊，雙套結我記得好清楚啊，因為以前咧雙套結咧喺呢個我仲係呢個童軍嘅時候咧，其實呢個結咧係非常之方便，同埋真係好快地就可以打到出嚟嘅一個結嚟嘅。佢咧，我諗你真係幾秒鐘、十秒都唔使就已經可以打到一個雙套結，而且咧佢係非常之快，啱啱講非常之快啦，同埋係好容易就可以打到，亦都咧係可以喺呢個繩同繩之間咧任意咧嘅地方咧去打結咧，就唔需要話一定要係喺繩頭嘅位置去打嘅。而佢受力之後嘅即係佢受力後嘅呢個繩咧嘅兩邊咧，亦都係可以負重嘅，所以相對嚟講咧呢個繩結咧係非常之方便，而雙套結咧係要反覆去練習嘅。如果唔係嘅話咧，就會咧好容易會係唔覺意打錯結，或者係你打極都好似打唔到咁嘅。好啦，到嚟緊要同大家講嘅咧，就係呢個連接繩同繩之間嘅一啲繩結啦，就係平結啦。第一個同大家講平結，我諗好多嘅有玩過童軍嘅朋友仔咧，應該都會知道平結其實係一個咧都幾都算廣泛，同埋係非常之簡單同埋好入門級嘅一個結嚟嘅。咁通常平結咧係要要嚟去連接兩條唔同或者更加多嘅繩啦。咁通常嚟講咧，呢個平結咧，大家咧記住一個原則，就係左搭右，右搭左咁樣嘅一個原則咧，就可以打到一個完美嘅呢個平結。而平結咧，佢雖然咧望落去好似好簡單咁樣，但係其實佢嗰、那個那個穩固程度咧，其實都唔會差過其他結嘅。而且佢咧亦都係好方便，可以俾你解開到個繩結嘅喎。掹一掹條繩尾咧，就已經可以將佢解開噶啦。而下一個咧，同大家講嘅咧，就係呢個魚人結同埋呢個雙魚人結。咁咧喺你登山嘅時候咧，比較跣嘅一啲繩咧，就好容易咧可以用呢個魚人結或者呢個雙魚人結咧，就可以將佢咧拼合埋一齊。咁咧，同埋可以係要嚟繞住一啲樹幹啊，或者一啲石頭去打結嘅，就可以確保咧呢個滑輪啊，同埋呢啲索帶啊等等啊，或者係一啲扣環咧，就係非常之穩固。而漁夫咧通常嚟用呢個結咧，就係要嚟咧係將好幾個嘅釣魚工具咧就穩固啊釣喺一齊嘅。而如果你喺呢個森林裡面啊，喺叢林裡面咧，面對一啲咧材質比較濕立立啊，一啲潮濕嘅一啲草啊嘅一啲情況底下咧，呢兩種嘅方法咧都係非常之好嘅一個選擇嚟嘅。咁其實咧咁其實佢都唔係話冇缺點嘅。其實佢受力咧，其實受力咗之後咧，其實係有啲難解開嘅，尤其是係濕咗或者一啲比較細啊、比較軟嘅一啲繩咧，就需要可能花上多啲嘅時間先至可以解開到呢個魚人結或者雙魚人結嘅。好啦，下一個 topic 同大家講嘅關於繩結嘅咧，就係方便咧由下降去即係方便你游繩用嘅一啲繩結啊。咁其實咧可能喺一啲攀登啊、攀岩啊、攀石啊等等嘅一啲活動底下咧，其實可能咧你會係需要用到一啲游繩嘅動作嘅。而以下落嚟咧呢個結咧就會係比較常見會用到嘅呢個結嚟嘅，就係叫普魯士爪結啊。咁其實咧佢呢個爪結裡面咧係非常之較常用啦，同埋非常 常之好容易就可以單手打得出嘅一個成結嚟嘅。咁其實咧，亦都係大家好熟悉嘅知道嘅呢個車夫式嘅呢個成結嚟嘅。咁其實咧，佢咧就擁有一個叫做滑式嘅呢個扣環啦。咁其實咧就可以咧係攀附喺一啲樹枝啊，或者係另外一條繩上面嘅。咁其實咧咁樣嘅時候咧。咁你企嘅位置或者你把手嘅嗰個位置咧，就唔會因為張力咧而又唔會因為呢個張力喺張力嘅底下咧而去變得太過跣啦。咁其實咧，你一鬆開咗呢、這個如果你一個張力鬆開咗。唔好意思啊，我個今日有少少唔係咁舒服，所以係咁咳啦。咁其實咧，如果咧呢、這個張力一旦鬆開咗嘅話咧，其實咧你嘅身咧就可能咧就會向前傾或者向後挨咗嘅。咁其實呢個結咧，其實最主要咧都係俾頭先講過啦，即、就、係、是、方便係去向下滑嘅一啲情況底下用嘅。所以咧，如果想學一下一啲唔同嘅結咧，依家我都係抽樣咁樣咧，將一啲比較常見少少嘅成結去話俾大家知嘅啫。咁其實市面上咧，或者可能好多資料上嘅話咧，其實有好多成結咧係未講到嘅。其實大家都可以上網揾下一啲資料性嘅嘢，因為有好多成結咧，其實都可以幫到我哋噶。咁其實點解我會特登去同大家講一啲成結嘅咧？因為其實喺野外求生嘅話咧，真係即係透過一啲繩索咧，其實係有好多唔同嘅成結嘅一啲配合咧，底下咧你就可以做出好多唔同嘅求生嘅一啲應用嘅一啲技巧啦，或者可能用喺唔同嘅工具上面咧，唔同嘅成結咧，真係可以令到我哋咧係減輕咗我哋嘅一啲負擔嘅喺求生方面。所以咧，我哋下一節翻嚟嘅時候咧，就會同大家講下咧，其實繩索除咗係一啲呢啲打一啲基本嘅成結之外，繩索咧其實仲有啲乜嘢特別嘅，或者一啲比較有創意嘅一啲 survival skill 啊。以下落嚟睇完呢條片之後。完咗今節，下一節翻嚟再同大家見。
What's going on, guys? Black Scout Survival, and today we're going to be showing you how to make the taut line hitch. And this is if you remember the guy line hitch, this is kind of similar. It's a tensioning line knot or hitch. So attaching to an object. It's pretty easy to use, and I like it. Some people like it versus the guy line hitch. It's kind of a toss up. For me, this is a little bit easier, like when you're rigging stuff down to your vehicle, you know, and things like that. But it has a lot of uses. Setting up tarps is one of the biggest things. But anyhow, what we're going to do is, you see I got my cordage around, or rope around this tree here, like I'd be setting up a tarp shelter, a guy line, ridge line. What I'm going to do is my working end, I'm going to place across on top of the standing end, and then I'm just going to reach my hand through the loop and flip it around. Now I'm going to do the same thing again, and that's going to create that wrap there. Now what I'm going to do is, parallel to the standing cord, the working end, I'm going to go under this time instead of over like I did on the front end. I'm going to go under and then pass this back through that loop I've created. And we've created that, you'll see it there, the triple knot there. And basically you can tighten this down as tight as you want. It's not gonna give up, it's gonna have friction. So you see there, really tight. Now this is a little bit easier to undo than the guy line. The guy line under tension gets kinda difficult, but for this, you just grab this tag in and pull it. Or you can slide it with your finger here. But easy to adjust, very easy and adjustable knot. And you can kind of set it however much you want to. But it's a good one to know, good one to practice, and you can use it for a lot of different things. Knot tying, like me and Jay was actually just talking about before this, this segment. Jay was an Eagle Scout, and he didn't remember how to tie this knot, so pretty funny that this is a perishable skill. So So again, what we're going to do is we're going to go over the top. We're going to go wrap around twice, creating that little barrel there. This time run it parallel, go under that loop you created and send that working in through that loop. And now you create that triple barrel there. You can just, you know, work it down. Just create that triple barrel there and you can tension it. Sorry, I didn't have that good enough, but good tension. Tensioning knot, tarps, all that kind of other stuff, so good things. Anyhow, guys, hope you enjoyed it. Make sure you subscribe to our channel. We put out a few new videos every week. Thanks for watching.
经错过我哋精彩嘅节目，而家上嚟呢个网址就可以订阅晒我哋八大频道。付费之后仲可以重温晒所有精彩嘅节目。记得要订阅我哋嘅 YouTube channel， 同埋赞好我哋嘅 Facebook 专页啊！